a rogue your face, marauding o'er the old disgrace that Black Fitzwilliam stormed your place and sent you to the fair. And Christ said victory was sure, soon the fireman teeth secure, until he met the Cled Malheur with Fake McHugh aboard. And Christ and swear, Lord Kildare, Fake will do what Fake will do.
When Queen Elizabeth came to the English throne in 1558, she continued the Irish policy of her father, Henry VIII, trying to expand the power of the English state to the lands which were controlled by semi-independent Irish lords. In Southern Ireland, this resulted in two consecutive rebellions between 1569 and 1583, both headed by the Earl of Desmond. Yet the second Desmond rebellion saw one particular event which would inspire the Irish nationalists of the 19th and 20th century, the Battle of Glenmalure, in which the Irish inflicted a heavy defeat on the forces of the English crown.
Follow me up the Carlo.
The second Desmond Rebellion and the Battle of Glenmalure are commemorated in the song Follow Me Up to Carlo. As with most songs we will later deal with in our film, this one has a traditional tune, while the lyrics were written by an Irish nationalist poet, Patrick McCall, in the early 20th century, when the rising Irish nationalism was in the need of new symbols for the national mobilization in Ireland.
No wonder that the version of history created in the song drastically differs from what really happened. We can actually call it an alternative history, with all the Irish uniting to push the English out from Ireland, and the stream of a Saxon Gaul flowing all over the island.
The author also uses a derogatory term, Saxons and the Baeric Gaels, to characterize the English and the Irish respectively. This shows a typical nationalist approach to history. If reconstructed history is unable to solve their goals, it should reconstruct it so that it would become an inspiration for the future. In this case, the future means Ireland without the English.
Follow me up the Carlo.